Welcome back, everybody. I've got the coals lit, and I've got my vortex bowl loaded up with Nakhla, pardon me, Earl Grey. That is my best attempt at saying that. I'm not even going to try to say that. There are Z's in places I didn't know there were Z's in, so meh. You guys know what I'm talking about right there. Okay. On to this. Because you know what it is now, I'm not even going to try to pronounce it. I'm just going to tell you it's Nakhla Earl Grey. I mean, it's your typical Nakhla cut, and it's your typical, that particular Nakhla, oily, not overly moist or anything, just real oily, real finely, kind of balls up because it is so oily. Now, this is my first time trying Nakhla Earl Grey. Puck told me I need to pick some of this up and give this a shot. So I went to my local tobacco shop, and they had 50 grams of it, rip-off for 50 grams. I won't say how much I paid for it, but I went ahead and picked some up. And I opened the package, and took the wrapper off and everything. It smelled a lot like lemon to me. That's not necessarily a bad thing, because sometimes lemon's good. And then I opened up and put it in my little Tupperware here, and I still smell the lemon. But it's not a fake lemon smell. Actually smells like a lemon oil, lemon zest type thing. It smells very, very good. Along with that, I smell kind of a tea smell. I've never actually drank Earl Grey tea. I'm not a big tea fan as it is. I do like a nice cup of chai in the evenings every now and then, but I'm not big on tea. I mean, chai is about as close as I get to tea, and that didn't even taste like tea to me, so. I couldn't tell you if this smells like Earl Grey. It smells like lemon and tea to me. So, I mean, I like the smell of this. It smells very, very good. And I love this particular brand of Nakhla. I love the oiliness of it. I love how long the flavor lasts of it. And I guess I'm so fond of it because they make my cinnamon. So, I really like this. I love the smell of this. As I said, I've got my Vortex bowl. I've got 3 Starlight Nats on there. I'm giving them a try. This is the first try ever trying them. Lighten them up. They really didn't smell too bad. They didn't smell as bad as Chronic Hookah Nats, but they did have more of a smell than Coconara's. So, I don't know if you're worried about the smell or not. I'm going to see how long these last, see if they're any good or not. Got my Syrian set up using the hose that came with it. What, 5-10 minutes? Closer to 5, I'm wanting to say, if I'm sitting here. Let's go ahead and give this a shot. Fantastic clouds coming off there. Oh my goodness, that is it's a very unique taste, and I've never quite tasted anything like that. I taste the lemon, and I taste this tea-y taste, I'm wanting to say, and then there's this aftertaste. It's a different aftertaste. Like I said, I've never had Earl Grey tea, so I couldn't tell you if it tastes like Earl Grey or anything like that, but it's got like this different aftertaste. And I can't pinpoint it. I've never tasted anything quite like this. It's not bad. I do like this one. I just wish I could pinpoint the aftertaste for you guys. It's bugging the crap out of me that I can't pinpoint it. But I like this one. As everybody says, this one, this Nakhla Earl Grey, is not for everybody. It's either you like it or you hate it. There is no in-between on this one. I actually like this. And I know Sam Hookah talks about taking Nakhla Earl Grey and just taking a pinch of Nakhla Orange and mixing it in there, and it's just a fantastic smoke. I don't have any Nakhla Orange. May pick some up and give that a shot. But this is very good. I may have to pick up 250 grams of this. This is definitely a great smoke and worth it. On to the Syrian now. It's got a tighter draw than what I'm used to. I'm not complaining. Not a bad thing. This hose is quite heavy. I mean, this little thing is short, but it is heavy. It's got a tighter draw than the cans. But, you know, they're one's Egyptian and one's Syrian. I like this a little bit better, I think. It's hard to explain, I guess. I don't know. You can kind of feel it, but it's not too tight where it restricts anything. It's just tight enough to get all the flavor and you just taste everything. I don't know. I can't really explain it, but it is tighter. If you haven't smoked out of a Syrian, then you probably won't understand what I'm talking about. But those of you who have and you like your Syrians, you know what I'm talking about. It's a tighter draw than your Kali Mamouns or an Egyptian Purian. But it doesn't restrict anything. I think it actually enhances the flavor more than the Kali Mamouns. I am very happy with this purchase. I like this. I'm liking this hookah. Not too crazy about the hose. I like the wider gauge hoses, but that's me. I'm liking the coals so far. I haven't really gotten into them. I'm not going to come back in 20 minutes. You guys know how Nakhla is. No point in telling you. In 20 minutes, Nakhla's flavor's still there. The claws are still there. Blah, blah, blah. You know what it is. I'm loving this hookah. I think I found my new favorite hookah. The other ones can take a backseat to this. I mean, I love my silk butterfly, but this Syrian just puts everything over the edge. I've been wanting a Syrian for a while. Mad Hatter was talking about having a Syrian. Mad Hatter, I got one before you did, hopefully. So, ha. Just kidding. You'll get one soon enough. Once again, this is Captain Howdy from hookahpro.com. Remember, hookahpro is your ultimate source for everything hookah. Thanks for watching.